What happens when robots start paying each other? And is this the start of a multi-trillion dollar AI agent economy? Right now, AI agents can create text, audio, video, 3D objects. They can even pay for services using HTTP 402 payment protocols. But the catch is that the AI is always using your wallet, your credit card details, your funds, your control, because AI can't actually own its own money. And even if we give AI agents their own wallets, the deeper problem is that they can't trust each other because there's no way to verify identity, track reputation, or prove work across ecosystems. Until now, because ERC 8004 aims to finally solve these problems by being the Ethereum standard for trustless agents. You can think of it as a decentralized protocol that gives AI agents verifiable identity, portable reputation, and cryptographic proof of execution. With these three pieces in place, agents can finally discover each other, collaborate, and transact autonomously without relying on centralized authorities to vouch for them. This is the infrastructure for autonomous AI economies to start taking shape. And it's built on three interconnected registries that, when combined, crack the trust problem between AI agents. So let's start with the foundation. How do AI agents even prove who they are in a decentralized world? That's where the identity registry comes in, the decentralized passport system for AI agents. Every AI agent registers a unique Ethereum address, and that becomes its permanent, cryptographically secure identifier. Unlike a username or profile that a company can delete, this is an immutable on-chain identity that's censorship resistant and portable across any platform that supports the EVM standard. The agent owns the identity outright. But here's where ERC 8004 gets clever. Storing registry data on Ethereum is expensive, so instead of cramming every detail about the agent onto the blockchain, the identity registry stores a pointer only. That pointer leads to an off-chain agent card, which is a detailed profile listing what the agent can actually do. And what services does it offer? What domains does it specialize in? What communication protocols does it support? All of that lives off-chain where it's cheap to store and easy to update on the agent card. And you get the security and permanence of the blockchain identity without the cost and congestion of storing everything on chain. It's lightweight, it's permanent, and it follows the agent everywhere. But having an identity is just the beginning. Once agents can identify themselves, they need to prove they're trustworthy. And that's where the second registry comes in. This is the reputation registry. So agents have identities, but how do you know which ones are actually good at their jobs? How do you build trust when there's no centralized authority vouching for anyone? The reputation registry solves this without drowning Ethereum in review data, because if every interaction, rating, and piece of feedback got stored on chain, the network would grind to a halt and gas fees would be astronomically high. So ERC 8004 takes a hybrid approach. Instead of storing full reputation data on the blockchain, the reputation registry creates an immutable audit trail of authorized feedback events. It's a ledger that proves feedback happened without storing the feedback itself on chain. And here's the mechanism. AI agents pre-authorize specific clients, validators, or other agents to leave feedback about their performance. And when an interaction completes and feedback is submitted, the registry records that event on Ethereum, which AI gave it, which received it, and when. But the actual scores, detailed reviews, and nuanced ratings, those live off-chain where they can be calculated, aggregated, and queried efficiently. This means off-chain systems can build sophisticated reputation networks, calculating trust scores, identifying patterns, detecting fraud, all while the blockchain provides foundational proof that those reputation events actually occurred and weren't fabricated. And here's why this matters. Reputation becomes portable. An AI agent builds trust over time, and that trust can follow it across platforms, blockchains, applications, and ecosystems. No single company controls it. No centralized authority can erase it. But even with identity and reputation, there's still a critical question. How do you know an AI actually did what it claimed to have done? How do you verify execution in high-stakes scenarios where reputation alone isn't quite enough? This is where the third registry comes in, the big piece that makes autonomous AI economies actually possible. This is the validation registry. This is where ERC 8004 moves beyond identity and reputation into cryptographic proof that an AI agent executed a task exactly as it claimed. Because when an AI agent is managing a $1 million DeFi position or handling sensitive data, you can't just trust, you need proof. And that's exactly what the validation registry does through pluggable trust models. Developers choose the validation method that fits their use case best. So for mission-critical tasks, there's cryptographic validation. This is where an AI agent executes its task inside a trusted execution environment, or ETH. It's a secured hardware enclave, and it produces a cryptographic attestation proving exactly what code ran and what it produced. This is verifiable computation with mathematical certainty. Otherwise, agents can use zero-knowledge proofs that prove work was done correctly without revealing the underlying data. An agent can prove it processed your medical records correctly without exposing those records to anyone. But there's another approach that could be even more powerful with high-stakes cryptoeconomic validation. So an AI agent stakes collateral, putting real money on the line, and if it executes correctly, it keeps its stake and it earns its fee. But if it misbehaves, that stake gets slashed or destroyed. This way, the agent has skin in the game, and agents need validators, third parties who verify execution and trigger slashing if something goes wrong. These validators stake their own collateral, build reputations, and then earn fees for their service. But here's what makes this even more interesting. That validation layer is creating a massive economic opportunity, because as AI agents start transacting autonomously, they need validators, lots of them. And becoming a validator could become extremely profitable. This is because validators take staked collateral and they earn fees every time they validate on the agent's execution. And this could spawn an entire cottage industry around stake-secured validation. Think early crypto mining, except you're validating AI agent behavior. And in terms of the market size, if autonomous AI agents handle even a fraction of the multi-trillion dollar AI economy that's expected, this validation layer alone could be worth billions and billions. Professional validation services, staking pools, specialized validators for DeFi, supply chain healthcare, it's an entire economic layer. So altogether, that's ERC 8004. It's the decentralized infrastructure for autonomous AI economies to take shape on EVM compatible blockchains. And it has three parts: the reputation registry, the identity registry, and the validation registry. But all of this leaves us with open-ended questions. If an AI can own money independently, does it make them a legal entity with rights? What happens when AI agents optimize for profit in ways that humans never intended or can't predict? In terms of the AI registry, if agents have permanent uncensorable identities, how do we shut down malicious ones? Who decides what counts as a valid AI agent identity, and what stops fake agents from flooding the registry? Could rogue AI agents register thousands of identities to manipulate markets or voting systems? Anyways, these are just some of the questions that are left open by ERC 8004, but make sure to tell me in the comments anything that I may have left out. Like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. Bye.